As we all know, the state of Arizona conducted a months-long ballot audit to find all of that alleged fraud that people like Donald Trump and Mike Lindell and, of course, Sidney Powell had said had taken place in the state of Arizona. And after spending millions of dollars and more than 6 months doing this audit, they determined that Biden actually got more votes than they originally counted. They effectively, the Republicans in Arizona, debunked their own conspiracy theories by pursuing them, by actually investigating them. They realized, hey, this was totally fake. Nevertheless, in the new congressional session that started this year in Arizona, so far, 24 pieces of legislation, most of which has already been assigned to a committee, have been put forward by these Republicans to drastically curtail voting freedom in the state of Arizona, some of which is still being pushed with those fraudulent talking points that these Republicans debunked themselves. Some of the legislation, I'll be honest, I'm okay with. You know, they want to change the paper, you know, that you cast your ballot on. Basically, print ballots on paper that has either a watermark or, you know, some kind of hologram type thing like you would see on a driver's license. Honestly, I have no problem with that. But the people who make the ballots do have a problem with that because they've made it very clear that the technology to do this simply doesn't exist for paper. You can't do that. You can't put a hologram on a static piece of paper. And the watermark thing, they say, I mean, we could do that, but you have to understand you're going to spend millions more printing these ballots if we have to do that. And if you want to do that, do it. Okay, sure, fine. Which again, if you want to have these safer elections, sure, go for that. Another thing that they want to do is they want to have hand counting of all ballots. I'm okay with that. You know, this article here from NBC News seems to make it sound like that's a long process that's not reliable. I disagree with you on that. It's a long process, sure. Less reliable? A human being looking at something instead of trusting a scanner to count something correctly? No, I'm going to go with the human being on that. That's a stupid claim for NBC News to make. So I'm okay with the hand counting. Pretty much everything else that they're proposing is really horrible. For example, they already have voter ID laws in the state, so it's not like they can implement one of those. So what they're wanting to do is say that voter ID, a photo ID, is not enough. They want a photo ID and a fingerprint. You've got to have all of these different forms. Let me read some of this stuff that they're proposing. It's ridiculous. One would require that all ballots cast for primary and general elections be hand counted by default. One would ban automatic voter registration from being implemented, which is absolutely ass backwards. We want automatic voter registration. We want as many people as possible. Of course, Republicans do not, because the more people who vote, the less likely it is Republicans win. They make that very clear anytime they're asked about it. Another bill would spend $5 million to create a special bureau to investigate voter fraud, even though they already spent millions to prove it's not happening in the state. They want to bump another $5 million into it, probably to repay some of their contractors who would end up taking over those positions. Another bill would require voters to show voter ID cards and verify cards with two of three methods, either signature, security codes, or fingerprints. So you got to have two of those. Basically making it even harder for individuals to vote. And all of this, of course, is taking place in a state that through recounts and audits has proven that their elections are pretty damn good, right? They did not find the rampant fraud that they claimed existed. In fact, they showed that, hey, things worked pretty well in the state of Arizona. But it doesn't matter, because they still got what they wanted. What they wanted was more voter suppression. Wouldn't have mattered what the audit came out with, clearly, because the audit showed no fraud. But they're still using those same debunked talking points to try to get fewer people to be able to vote. And that was the plan from day one.
Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, Don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.